Hi, Linda Voorhees here, VoorScript.com, and I've been waiting to do a reading for you. I wanted to kind of wait until I was in the mood to do it. And because it is Good Friday, a rather dark day in the Christian calendar, and not just Good Friday, but Good Friday in Southern California, which you would think, because it's spring, it would be bright and sunny, pastels, lots of signs of spring. Well, instead it's dark, it's drizzly, it's overcast, it's raining off and on, and it's cold. And maybe it's my Welsh heritage. It doesn't take much to get me melancholy. But I just am in that brooding mood today. So I thought, well, maybe this is the day to do the reading that I had been wanting to do for you. And it's a reading that I did a few years back when I had a couple of clients who were doing, separately they were doing pilots for the networks. And the further we went into the process of writing and rewriting the process and, you know, getting the notes back from the executives, and there was sort of this, on each project, because they were separate projects, there was a cycle of hysteria. And the hysteria was about, I'm so close and I can almost touch it, and if I fail at this point, I don't know what I'll do. And believe me, I understand it. I absolutely understand it. Because we are professional writers. Not only do we want recognition for our good writing, but we also want to be paid for our talent, paid for our voice, and then beyond that, recognized for the words we put on the page that are then translated to the screen. And that translation, we hope and we pray, will engage an audience in a visceral manner. So, you know, we don't make too many demands of ourselves, but as we are engaged in that professional part of, our writing, that we have to fulfill something for a producer, for a director, for an executive, we sometimes get into this, what I would call the noise of hysteria and the energy of desperation, rather than focusing on the work in a way that we can deliver our best writing, which means to say that we can translate the truth that is within us, that we can find a way to express our fear and then somehow give definition of resolving that fear through love, right? So this is what I'm going to read for you today. I do apologize that it's not memorized. You know, I wrote it. You would think that I would have it memorized. I've only read it, I don't know, maybe a couple of hundred times, but I haven't memorized it. I wonder if Walt Whitman had all of his poems memorized. I bet he did. I bet he did. But on the other hand, what else did he have to do, right? I mean, comb his beard, please. Having said that, I do want to read this to you, and I'm giving this to you, writer to writer. Embrace the silence. Writing comes to you in the quiet spaces. The silence is your refuge and your healing. When fear constantly harangues at you, when doubt nags at you, when the head noise of the world screams at you, these are the times when you must become quiet. The less mature writer will try to deafen the noise by creating more noise. The confident writer will simply become quiet, diminishing all noise. It is in the moments of silence that the truth will come to you. If you are a person of faith, it is called prayer. If you are a person of discipline, it is called meditation. If you are a writer, it is called regeneration. There is no shame in need. There is no harm in fear. Writers must feel the entire range of human emotion to truly convey the truth of our very existence. Need and fear are your connection to the human race. Need and fear will give you the gifts of humility, compassion, and meekness, all attributes necessary to providing you with the depth of heart, soul, and spirit that are required of every writer. The shame comes in your moment of desperation. It's the moment you stop trusting the truth that is within you. Desperation makes you bargain for a moment of glory rather than sacrifice for the greater nobility. Then curse the very weakness that is the perpetual residue of desperation's legacy. When you're quiet, your story will tell you what it wants to be. Your story doesn't come to you through the noise of the outside world. It is deep within you, waiting to be heard. Listen. It is in the silence that you will hear it. Be quiet. Simply